Hello everyone, welcome back. We're making a Bento Macropad today.
The Bento Macropad is a 5-key, 3D printed, open source macropad designed by u/nguyedt. I will leave the link to the GitHub repository in the description below. Today's video is extra special because I'm going to be running a small group buy on this macropad at the time of uploading this video. I'll leave links with information about the group buy in the description as well. We've worked really hard to bring this group buy to everyone, so I hope you enjoy. We're going to start off by unboxing the PCBs. The first time I made this macropad, I did it hand-wired, but soon decided that I wanted to make more. Since hand-wiring is pretty tedious, I decided to get PCBs printed to make the process cleaner, easier, and more simple. On the PCB, you can see the Bento graphic as well as the designer's name. We're also going to be using a Pro Micro for this build. The Bento cases are printing steadily, and the first step after taking it off the print bed is to remove the supports. These prevent warping and help the case keep its shape while printing, but can be difficult and tedious to remove. In this particular case, there are three layers of supports to remove, with the third one being the most difficult. After the supports are removed, we can see a clean Bento case, ready to go. Here, I'm showcasing what a white Bento case would look like under direct sunlight. However, please keep in mind that the specific white filament shown in these clips is not the white filament that will be used in the group buy, which will be more opaque. You can see examples of the new white filament in the intro and outro clips. As you can see, the bottom plate should friction fit tightly into the top case with a nice click. I've made some modifications to the 3D print file compared to what is in the GitHub repository. The most apparent change is that the bottom plate is one solid piece, as compared to the one available online, which has a hole in the bottom for the reset switch. For this build, we are going to be using Kalebox Navy switches. A variety of switch options will be available for the group buy. Here's the rotary encoder and knob as well. Let's quickly assemble. First, the rotary encoder. Next, the first side of the Pro Micro pins. Then, pop the switches in and solder these as well. Then, the Pro Micro itself is attached to the macro pad. Finally, screw in the rotary encoder washers, pop on the bottom plate, and we're done. We have some very special artisans prepared for this build. These are the pastel rainbow grunt and matching blank from No Name Caps. I love the finish and colorway of these artisans, and you can see that everything about the caps is meticulously perfect. These resin cast artisans fit on all my switch stems perfectly and need no adjustments. We're going to fill the rest of the macropad with the OWO and Punished Numbskull set from Rejects Caps, which I showcased in a previous video, and a lavender rose from Capsmiths. Finally, I will flash the macropad, which I'll explain in more detail in an upcoming video. Since we removed the reset switch hole to give a cleaner, sleeker look, the physical reset switch unfortunately had to be removed as well. However, resetting it is still easy. Simply take a pair of tweezers or anything metal, like a paperclip, and short these two points on the PCB. Make sure to do it twice in quick succession, which is necessary because of the Pro Micro. You'll see the lights on the Pro Micro flash when you reset it. Don't forget to always reinforce your Pro Micros with hot glue, like I showed in the MB17 numpad video. And we're all done. All the links to information about the group buy will be in the description below. I hope you enjoyed, and thank you for watching.